What's up, guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Elden Ring, Kita, Edition! Remember last episode where I died a whole lot? Neither do I. It didn't happen. Take it out of your mind. It's a lie. Didn't happen. This episode is gonna go so smoothly. So smoothly. You're gonna be like, Kita? Dying? Nay. Does not happen. Especially when he misses his jumps because I do R2 instead of R1. When I should have done an R1. Especially then. Okay. Actually, I'm going to turn up the volume a little bit because I can't hear crap. Crapola. And you know what else I'm going to do? Go to YouTube Studio so I can read some comments. Each time Dave dies, I go dadass. From Crossover Club. For the comments like that. Oh, I almost just died because I was not really paying the type of attention I should. You know what this reminds me of? There actually is a cave that I never figured out like how to get to one part of it. Just reminded me of that, basically. Okay. This is dangerous territory here. This be dangerous territory. We get some demi-humans. Oh my god, demi-humans. This is like a boss fight. Literally, because it was a boss fight. They're falling from the skies! Uh-oh. Oh my. Okay. Again, not like these guys are ever an issue, it's just the amount of them. So they're falling from that thing. Okay. Hey, you know, that's not a bad thing. It means it probably leaves it opened up for me. I'm starting to freak out. Like, what if I'm not recording properly? What if I messed everything up? What if I am a failure? Okay, for real cave, I feel like I missed a whole area and spot. Because this isn't going to be all there is to it. I see that. Okay. Let me keep on checking for hidden walls. And I know that there's a torch you can use, by the way, the sentry torch for this stuff, because some of you guys have commented on it. But I don't have any faith, and I'm pretty sure you need the faith requirement for it to work. I know you can hold it, but I'm just not sure if it works or not without that. Also, I don't think I've found the sentry torch yet anyways. No, I haven't, so. Some of you guys were also saying that I guess you can use one of the... Yeah, see, that's going to be death. Oh, here it is. Here's the way. What do you know, way? Golden Rune 6. Wow. Yeah, some of you guys were saying that I guess you can use Margit Shackle, and that's another way to open up secret passages, which is interesting. I had no idea about that. So that might be a good quick way. Okay. That targeting. That quick targeting switch on. I mean, I guess I could have just killed the boss first to save myself some trouble. I keep on pressing circle when I'm supposed to be pressing a different thing. Alright, you know what? Screw it. I'm gonna come in loud and clear. Yeah, that rolling. That rolling is where it's at. Meh! Done. Actually, I feel like I'm surprised there's not a demi-human chief here. Maybe he'll, like, bounce in a moment. Arterial Leaf. Yes! Yes! I was going for that! Hell yeah! Coil Shield. Ooh, okay. More snake stuff in Mount Gelmir. I didn't expect it. I never saw it coming! Armament designed for gladiatorial combat. Rises above its peers as a particularly showy specimen. The sculpted bronze snake is a poison breed, boosting the wielder's resistance to poison. Okay, the gladiatorial combat aspect of it makes me think that's related to Volcano Manor and how maybe their origins in a way? Because they like going to attack people, basically. They're not like the Fingers of Blood or the blood cult, essentially. They have their own reasons, but They also do a lot of invasions, and so the gladiatorial combat thing actually makes sense with them, I think. Or would align with it. Specifically that faction of the Volcano Manor. Hey, demi-human queen, Margit. Now I get to fight one without my trusty steed. Okay, what you gonna... Oh my god, I did not know about that. Alright. Just tossing the scepter away? Okay, that was kind of funny, actually. Okay, what does the purple eye indicate? That's gotta be important, I'm sure. Because the glowing of the eyes in this game is always really indicative of things, and I actually don't know what purple is. Because, you know, the insane one is so, ooh, clear. Purple wouldn't be magic either, so... I'm guessing it's... Oh, sick. I'm guessing it's some sort of insanity, right? Because she tossed away the, Perceptor. Jar Cannon. Oh, Berserk, here we come! Jar Cannon, baby! Even though I'd get too heavy by equipping it. Where is the Jar Cannon? Jar Cannon, which uses explosives to fire great bolts. Deals great damage, but is slow to reload. Experimental firearm brought to the assault on Volcano Manor, where it was discovered that no one knew how to use it. Just want to see how berserky you look with it. Uh-huh. Did I put it on the wrong hand? I did put it on the wrong hand. Okay. Where is it? It's really just to look at how berserky I look with it. Alright, let's see. Yes! not very berserky. As it doesn't change your hand. That's so sad. Well, this ended up being a far easier dungeon than I thought it would be, to be honest. I didn't play as well against the Demi-Human Queen as I would like to have, but because I was doing a lot of dodges I didn't need to. It's kind of like superfluous dodges, but you know, that's okay. I'm still happy with the results of that, so. Nomadic Merchant there. All right, well, I'm going to do what I talked about before, because it drives me crazy not to have a map. Then again, I know if I go to the 9th Gelmir site, that's how I can get to my map, but I'm going to go back to the Erdtree Gazing Hill. And I'm going to continue the Altus Plateau, finally. And, yeah. Do some Altus Plateau stuff. Actually, speaking of which, if I go up there, this ruin here is actually going to be... It's at the Lux Ruins. It's actually the top area there that I need to get to. But, let's see if this is going to take me up there. I'm not honestly sure if this is the path to go up there, if I need to go the other way. Looks like I need to go from the other side. Well, good to know. But yeah, the Lux Ruins, there's not anything you can really get from this part of it, which really confused me at first, because I was like, wait, there's got to be something here, right? Got to be something. Oh my god, wait a second. There is something there. Millicent. Really? I didn't know she ended up here. All right.
I've been waiting for you. I knew you had the stuff of champions. I hereby invite you to the Volcano Manor. Take my hand and have audience with my mistress.
I thought I was already invited, but fine, we'll do it. We're gonna skip ahead to the Volcano Manor.
That you follow the same path as Lady Tanith.
You know, I keep on getting pulled away from the Altus Plateau. I wonder what triggered her to show up there, because I didn't spot her in my previous game when I went here. Unless I did her questline afterwards, and maybe that was the case. Alright, we're at the Volcano Manor, which is pretty great. Alright. That I got this nice little skip. Also, honestly, I do wonder if I can just go outside from here. I can, which is nice, because that means I can just go get the map fragment that's been driving me crazy. But yeah, I'm just like, everything in Mount Gelmir without the map fragment.
Brave Tarnished. Welcome to the Volcano Manor. I am Tanith, the proprietress of this house. Raya spoke well of you, a warrior of promise, I believe she said. Perhaps you are prepared to make a commitment. Will you join us here at the Volcano Manor and resist the tide? Why accept the burden of their grace or be fooled by the dogmatic ramblings of the fingers. Rise with us against the Erd Tree.
So this is one of the factions I was talking about who is anti-Erd Tree, anti-Two Fingers, and I was just talking about them anyways, so it's a good thing we're running into them.
Interesting. Your decision is most welcome. Now you belong to the Volcano Manor family. The drawing room lies down the hall. Make yourself comfortable, but be sure to earn your keep.
Drawing room key. Thank you.
The drawing room is through the hall. Use the key I handed you, and make yourself comfortable.
Okay, so I'm guessing that that depiction up there is of Rykard. So that'd be my guess. This is her.
The drawing room is through.
Yeah, he just won't talk to you at this point. I don't think he ever talks to you, actually. I think he remains silent. Her guard. And I think Raya is going to hang out in one of these rooms so we can talk to her as well. Perfume bottle. All right. Why is there a dead perfumer here? I don't know. Also, I can't use my weapon in here. I can use it when I go upstairs. Another thing to note is you can actually screw yourself out of Raya's questline, which I accidentally did, by going too far. Don't have to worry about it yet. It's only once you start progressing through the legacy dungeon here. So I think that's just worth pointing out and noting. You know, actually, what would be nice is the lantern. This is a good time to use it. All right. Let me just click and make sure my computer doesn't overheat because it's kind of hot in this room. Yeah, so annoyingly, you can't open this door here. And actually, I think I found the backside and never was able to open it, which super drove me crazy. All right, so there we have Raya. And that is Bernal, the guy who is at the War Master Shack. So he's now going to be in this location, which is interesting that he shifted spots. Let's talk to Raya first.
Hello again, brave Tarnished. As a scout, I am pleased to see you again here at the Volcano Manor under Lady Tanith's guidance. May you tread the path of valor. Brave Tarnished, under Lady
All right, Bernal.
You, what in heaven's name are you doing here? The Volcano Manor is a pit of recusants who spit at grace and hunt our own kind. I hope you understand the weight of my words.
Well, as long as you understand what you're saying.
I thought you were tarnished, bred by virtue.
Perhaps playing that part led you to your doubts, I wonder. But know that the path you walk is blasphemy and leads only to a miserable death. Before you consider hunting any of your own kind, think on that.
It's interesting that he even, like, is kind of against it. But yeah, so Bernal, that's nice that we're seeing all those names there. Actually, it's not showing all of them, which is interesting. It's only showing the ones I've talked to so far. So Recusant Bernal, if you recall, was, where is it? Up here. He was at the Warmaster Shack, and now he's gone, and he's left for this area.
This blasphemous path leads only to a pitiful death. Before you consider hunting any of your own kind, think on that.
Okay.
It's you, is it? Well, nice to see you again. So you've been invited as well, I see. Then we're comrades in arms henceforth. You watch my back, and I'll watch yours. Yes? I can tell. You're wondering about Lanya. Well, you see, after much internal debate, I've come to realize revenge is not the answer. According to Lady Tanith, I've got the stuff of champions. And champions, ironic as it is, are oft forced to walk a tainted path. It hit me like a bolt from the blue that my former thoughts were simple naivety. Of course, my heart weeps for Lanya. That unfortunate incident was a cruel twist of fate indeed. But succumbing to the pain and sadness caused won't make me a champion, will it? Lanya knows this, I'm certain. Fate has laid hard roads for us both. but such is true of any road trod by champions.
So you kind of find out a little bit more about him later on and why he is kind of changing his tune here, because before he was so against the Volcano Manor. He's going to go there for revenge. How dare they kill Lanya? And now he's just switched sides and flip-flopped. But it says a lot to his personality, and eventually we actually do find out a little bit of why, and I think it's a lot of insecurity on his end with him talking to Lady Tanith and being like, you be a champion. It's really playing into an insecurity this character has.
I always resented these hands. Their pale complexion, a far cry from any warriors. The shame of House Hoslow, but that won't be the case for long. They'll be darkened by grit once I've set out on the path of champions. The tale of House Hoslow is told in blood after all.
Okay, so remember how we were talking to Jarbaron, and Jarbaron was like, you don't have hands that are good enough. Now he's talking about his hands not being warrior hands, so... Interesting connection there.
I always resent a pale
that he very specifically says that. Dialos here. Okay, so... Letter from the Volcano Manor and our Recusant Finger. So, again, Recusant Finger different from a Festering Bloody Finger. They both attempt invasions of other players' worlds, but again, it's different, and that's important for lore reasons. It's not consumed upon use, whereas the Bloody Finger is. Then again, here you have the Bloody Finger, the normal Bloody Finger, where, so it's the same as a normal Bloody Finger, but this is going to be your other way to just do unlimited invasions. Attempt invasion of another player's world. If successful, you'll arrive as an invader recusant with the objective of defeating the host and fingers of that world. This frill finger is covered in snake scales instead of blood, right? Snake scales this time. Again, we've been hearing a lot about snakes related to this area. An heirloom of the Lord of the Volcano Manor bequeathed to tarnish who become family. So now we have snakes involved with this specific one. Okay. Also, we get our letter. A written request from Volcano Manor disclosing the name of a tarnished to be hunted. Old Knight Istvan. He can be found in Limgrave. Find the red mark on your map for the exact location. These are all pretty easy to find as it literally just gives you a red mark. I'm not going to do these yet, though, because it's going to screw over some allies that you can have in Caelid. But just because we got this introduction to the faction, it was worth going into since that was new for me. And let's just open up this door. And eventually we will come back and do a lot of Volcano Manor stuff. But again, it's just, for me, it wasn't worth it yet. And there's going to be a whole bunch of story stuff. There's also Invader up there that I could take on. We're also going to find... Oh, wait. Patches is supposed to show up here eventually. Another locked door here. Plenty of locked doors. You know what? I'm going to just go ahead and head out right now. I know I'm not doing the top portion, but again, I just keep on not meaning to be in Mount Gelmir, and the game just keeps dragging me in. So, main thing I'm going to do, number one thing here... Wow, I do, like, no damage to him. Actually, you know what? I'm going to hop off my horse. I don't like fighting these guys on my horse. Yeah, actually, I guess the damage I'm doing to him is fine. I take it back. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. I'm not even dying from him. Jesus. Hey, look, a ghost here.
Someone please kill him. That horrendous serpent. Praetor Rykard.
Actually never found this guy before.
You're tarnished. Here to put the demigods to the sword. Then please, kill the great serpent. The one that devoured Praetor Rykard. I left the serpent slaying spear in the Lord's chamber. Worthy tarnished. Brandish the spear and run him through. The great serpent. That unspeakable monstrosity.
Okay, who is that then? Raya the Scout, Tanith, Rekkies and Bernal, Knight Dialos. All right. I think when we find his weapon, it says the name of him.
To Rykard's ambitions, though blasphemous, marked him a worthy sovereign, but they were reduced to gluttonous depravity once he gave himself to the serpent. Whatever that thing is, it is no longer Praetor Rykard. Someone must kill him to spare him and his ambitions from further dishonor. Worthy tarnish, it is the run.
Okay, a whole bunch of things here. We've heard before about how Rykard succumbed to gluttony, right, and all that. And now he's being put hand in hand with this giant serpent, basically. So it really changes Rykard. And, like, this guy, according to this guy, it changed who Rykard is. And it changed Praetor Rykard's, like, who he was as a person. And that aligns with the fallout of the people who followed him. And this guy probably followed him and now hates him. As he was saying that, his blasphemy, which is likely him going against the greater will, is what made him a leader worth following.
Did you read the letter left for you? That is the task the Volcano Manor desires you enact. You will be compensated once the deed is done. Good luck. If you are loath to hunt your own kin, so be it. But you must leave this house at once. This is a war against the Erdtree. We have no place for the meek, nor the luxury of keeping clean hands. The letter describes the task. The Volcano will be compensated.
Yeah, so these tasks are going to be a really good way to get various armor and items and such. I guess I'll talk to Raya again, see if she has anything new.
Brave Tarnished, under Lady Tanith's gut.
Nope. What about Bernal?
This blasphemous before you can...
Nope. And...
I always resent the pain.
No,
but
okay, but Patches did show up, so we're going to go ahead and talk to Patches. Yeah, that ghost is interesting, and I want to go get capture that's clean for lore videos of him.
Well, you joined the manor, huh? I don't believe it. Didn't think you had it in you. And here I thought Raya was barking up the wrong tree. All good, though. We're on the same side now. We'll do good work together.
So Patches can actually help you against one of the bosses, and I'm hoping he still appears after this has happened, but I guess we'll find out.
Oh, and of course, we can do business if you like. Patches Emporium at the Volcano Manor. Specially for you.
Alright. Hey, what about you, Patches?
Are you surprised that I belong to the Volcano Manor? I always hated the gibberish about Lost Grace and the laughable Two Fingers. I thought I could lend a hand in unmasking the charade. Not to mention, Tanith has always made me curious. I guess her master must really be something, because she's pretty damn smug about it. Even after announcing her blasphemous ambitions, she still stands proud. I've never seen a woman quite like her.
It's interesting that they aren't necessarily on the side of, No, there's different... I guess I should say it's interesting to me that there's different sides and factions against the Erdtree who aren't aligned.
Try to find it in your heart, Nick.
And something also worth talking about with the Two Fingers that I didn't really think about before, but it's kind of a cool just little note, is that, you know, the Two Fingers and Three Fingers are the two major they're two of the major factions in the way, but obviously a full hand is Two Fingers plus Three Fingers, so it's kind of just funny in a sense that That would be a full hand, you know? That when you combine them, and one is order and one is chaos, is the other thing about them. Oh my god. Okay, let's go back inside for a moment. I hope I don't die while I do that. Great. Hopefully he just killed all those things for me. It's interesting, actually, to me that... There's a bunch of chaos ones, right? Or frenzied like, this guy's frenzied is what I mean to say. Or mad. I guess the word's mad. I was using frenzied before, but it would be mad. It's a madness, I say. Utter madness. There we go. After that embarrassing moment last time, let's take him out proper like. Thank you very much. Thank you. Not that I really needed to for anything, it was just for the personal need, I suppose. Okay. Good thing about this is I'm, as I mentioned, I'm really close to the map fragment, and I can fill that in finally. As it was driving me absolutely crazy. I think I'm also close to a site of grace here. Interesting that there's a bunch of trolls being hung here when, you know, one of them was just guarding the manor. I don't know. Interesting to me. Alright, we get a golden seed, and looks like there's still one there. Okay, there we go. Yeah, there's like, there's gonna be a ton, though, at the Altus Plateau, as I said before. And I'm gonna try to kill this thing. You know, actually, I wonder if this makes it easier to kill, is doing, like, holding down the R2, L2 thing. For some reason, I never really thought to do that, but it's like, why not? Yeah, that was way better. Ash of War through and through. Ash of War through and through. There it is. Through and through, powerful archery skill, using a great bow held in an oblique stance. Ready the great bow, then twist the bowstring to fire a mighty great arrow that can penetrate through enemies. Okay, going back to comments, by the way. Lexington Show says, I'm pretty sure finger creepers were created by Rykard, as he is strongly connected to blasphemy and his hands that look just like a finger creeper in his current form. Okay, yeah, so that's something related to when we actually will find Praetor Rykard. So I don't want to go too much into that, but that is worth mentioning, especially since we see some finger creeper right here. Speak of the devil. But that's a really good connection that I hadn't made, to be honest, that it looks like his hands. And I guess I thought about that when I first fought him, that he had those, like, cool, creepy hands like this. But that was about as far as I went with it. But that is really good that is a really good analogy or note there. We find the finger creepers throughout a lot of the game, though. And also, hands in general are a big theme in the game. So, while that connection is really interesting, it is also worth, unless there's more clues than just that one visual, it is worth considering everything. Like, the fact that there's the two fingers, the three fingers. We find these creeper hands, like, here. We find them in, what's it called? Caria Manor, we find them way later in the, like, in other later areas that I don't think Rykard's associated with. So, oh my. And I don't think there's any, well, actually, I take it back. I was gonna say I don't think there's any association with Rykard and the manor, but that'd be wrong, since he was raised by Rinala and all them, and that's where she grew up. That was her line, so I take that back, actually. So that is another connection. Right there. So at least there is a connection then to Caria Manor. I'm not sure about the spot later on, but it's definitely worth thinking about and keeping in mind, because maybe there is. Maybe there is. Alright, Mount Gelmir's map. Very nice. And I'm not going to keep going that way, as there's a tree avatar I just don't feel like dealing with right now. But, I guess I'll get the Lord Rykard. If this putrid field of death is what your blasphemy would bring, then I can no longer abide. No one can. So, yeah, again, just people disagreeing with Rykard, probably deserting him, it seems like. So maybe they did just desert him, as that one item description could have been saying. Mount Gelmir's map, finally! Finally! Alright, expanded my map, and look how big the map just got thanks to that. You know what? Whatever, I'm here. I will try to deal with this thing. That's what quick cuts are for, right? I do want to look at the description for the map before I forget, though. So, Mount Gelmir. Mount Gelmir, which houses the Volcano Manor at its summit, is characterized by sheer cliffs and ominous skies. These qualities only became more pronounced after the shattering. I wonder if there's any specific reason for that, or if it maybe it has to do with Praetor Rykard. Because I'm thinking that stuff with Praetor Rykard happened after the shattering with him, the blasphemy and all that sort of stuff, but it's hard to tell as I haven't pieced together a specific timeline yet. Because it seems to me a lot of the problems really started before the shattering, even though a lot of blame is placed on the shattering in the game to you. I think a lot of it was really an underbelly going on in an undercurrent beforehand. Alright, Archery Avatar, we'll see how this goes, because I'm probably a little under-leveled for it. Probably. Yeah, we'll see. We shall see. But, yeah, another minor Urchry there, and Ulcerated Tree Spirit. Oh! I thought it was an Urchry Avatar, I guess I was wrong. Alright. You know what, I don't remember if it's easier or harder to fight this guy on Torrent. But I guess it'll be interesting to find out. Oh! Right now, Torrent's not doing too hot. I'm gonna have to heal Torrent, actually. You know, I'm used to fighting these things off of Torrent, so maybe that would be a better idea, just for that sake of what I'm used to. Alright, let's see. Please don't die, Kita. Please don't die. At least it's not one-hit kills, I guess? Oh my god! Nope! Okay. Get out of the fire! Get out of that fire! Can I not get the eye? Of course I can't get it. Of course I can't get it. You know what I'm realizing? This might be the first real ulcerated tree spirit fight that I'm doing with on this Let's Play. Because the other one got totally screwed. By no fault of my own, I will say. You know, it just kind of glitched on me. That wasn't on me. And then I felt guilty about it and was trying to make him work again, so... let me just point that out, okay? Oh god. Oh god. Nope! Honestly, I don't remember that attack, so I'm glad it ended okay. Just for that reason. How about that? I didn't really purposely get that timing, but... Oh god, come on. Oh, oh my god! I can't believe I stunned him at like the perfect timing to pull out that stun. That was incredible. And it gives me just enough to get a level up. Alright, Leaden Hard Tier and Cerulean Hard Tier. Let's look at them. Leaden and Cerulean. Cerulean, a crystal tier formed slowly over the ages where the Erdtree's bounty falls to the ground. Can be mixed in the Wonder's Physic. The resulting concoction restores half of one's maximum FP. And the other one was... I thought I remember the word hard. Oh, there it is. Was it the hidden tier then? Uh-oh. Can be mixed with the resulting concoction eliminates all FP consumption. However, this effect is only brief and will quickly expire. It might have been the hidden tier that I got, actually. So what was the other one? Why do I not remember? Am I going crazy? Oh, there's the Leaden Hard tier. This is the other one. Resulting concoction temporarily boosts one's poise. Cool. Good stuff. I thought I saw an item over here that I didn't pick up. It was like by one of the fires. Ah well. I'll check it out later, I guess. Later! You know what? I can go at this point, just run back and get... should I? I know there's gonna be an invasion, but I was gonna say, like, this pretty much just leads me back to the beginning. There is another boss at Mount Gelmir I haven't fought yet, who's by the, where is it? By the 9th Mount Gelmir campsite. I'm surprised that's the only one that's giving me that. Oh yeah, well there's a couple campsites actually in the beginning I haven't grabbed for, Sites of Grace. Okay, where is the one that I was seeing the item before I dropped down? Alright, I guess I'm not finding it. I'm just gonna move on. Whatever. Whatever. I tried. I gave it my all. It's not here. I must have just picked it up along the way. Hey, but there's this. Drawstring fire grease. Just what I needed. Okay. Beast blood, and honestly, there's not really any reason you need to drop down here. This is just kind of showing you where Dead End from before was, but might as well show it off. So, if you ever wondered, Stone Sword Key, and look at all these deaths, probably from the war that was going on in the battle. So, yeah, if you ever wondered what was going on, or, sorry, where that led to, this bridge that's broken, that's the other side of it. And I believe I am Corpse Den Shack. Golden Vow. Nice. Ah, shit. No! I think I'm actually pretty close to the... I don't know what I was going to say. I know I'm close to the invasion, but... Golden Vow. Where is it? There it is. An incantation of Erdtree worship. This incantation has been taught to knights of the royal capital for generations, and knights sent on distant expeditions lean on it as a source of courage. So, basically, I think it's, to me, just clear that it's part of the war, right? So he's going against the Golden Order, Rykard, and so this is a bunch of the Golden Order coming to attack him, and that's the war that's going on over here. So, yeah, it's like Rykard and his minions versus the Golden Order. Playing off of that blasphemy. And I think there's an evasion somewhere around here that's supposed to happen. And I don't know why it isn't. I thought I remembered that, and that's very weird to me that it's not happening, but... I guess that's okay. Explosive Great Ball. I'm gonna have to look it up. It's not okay, actually, because I want the invasions. Unless it's maybe it's someone from the Volcano Manor who's not invading me because I'm a part of it. I'll have to look it up, who I got invaded by. You see a lot of those abductor versions there. It's because it was made by Praetor Rykard. He created those. At least that's my understanding, or his faction did, since the home of them. They transport you to the Volcano Manor, right? So to me, that would speak to it being a Praetor Rykard thing. At least that's my personal interpretation. We're now at the base of Mount Gelmir. And I do have some stuff I have to come back and do here again that I will do later on, even though at this point I've done most of Mount Gelmir. Okay, let me give myself some more vigor again, just to keep on raising that up a little bit. But there's a base camp up here that I haven't gone to that you can climb up to. Looks like there's another dungeon there, which might be another Mount Gelmir dungeon. Okay, Nomadic Merchant. There's a... So you go up there and come across here, and then there's going to be another boss by the 9th Mount Gelmir boss site, or sorry, campsite is going to be right up there. But yeah, let's go back to, once again, the Erdtree Gazing Hill, which is right there. All right, Erdtree Gazing Hill. Wow, I'm looking at the time, and this really has been basically another Mount Gelmir episode. It's kind of going to be half-half, I guess, but... alright, well, hey, that's the fun of exploring. You just find random stuff. I don't think there are any other NPCs I wanted to talk to here. I'm hoping to run into one up ahead, though. Which is going to be our bro who left, who's looking for Gold Mask. So I do want to run into him. And actually, you know, while I'm going through these campsites and these areas, it's a good time to... We're going to want to go through there, by the way, but eventually. But might as well just take them out, because there are items in here, like any of the campsites. Although I'm not seeing where the enemies attacking me are. Well, don't mind if I do. Oh, there's the ballista up there. Great Shield Talisman. I'll take a look at it in a moment. I got to take care of these guys. Hopefully I'll remember, because I seem to forget a lot of this stuff. I'm getting old, man. I'm forgetting things. I'm just an old man. Alright. I think I'm safe up here. Well, let me take care of this guy. This is working out quite nicely. Oh, another guy there. Whoa, bro. I was not expecting that. I really was not. Alright, well, anyways, yeah, I think I'm actually a little over-leveled now for this area. Great sword, great shield talisman. Can I look now? Can I look now? I'm gonna hop on this ballista. I guess not. Alright. Boost guarding ability, talisman depicting a knight holding a great shield. The Knights of Laendale once modeled themselves after the tree sentinels. Their purpose is to protect that which deserves protection, and thus the shield always comes before the sword. So, Laendale modeling himself after tree sentinels, who I think we found out a little bit about, but the tree sentinels were basically just there to guard the Erd Tree, so that makes sense with Laendale, as it's the capital city where the Erd Tree is located. And, okay, let's go through here and see if there's anything else I might have missed in this camp, although I don't think so. Looks like there isn't. Oh wait, actually, here we go. There was. Gotta keep an eye out for these carriages. Troll's Golden Sword. Alright, let's take a look at that in my Ultra Great Sword section, probably. My Ultra Great Sword section, there it is. Sword given to the lesser giants who fought for the Erd Tree during the war against the giants long ago. Though they have lost their minds, they stay inseparable from their swords that are in a sad shape, such that the gold plating had flaked away. So, I guess they're lesser giants, which makes sense, as they're not quite as big, but they join sides with the Golden Order, interestingly. So, alright. A cool little backstory to those guys. Warming stone. Anything else going to be in this encampment? I guess not. But perhaps this one with the pumpkin head. Yeah, look how much more damage I did to this guy rather than the one that was in Volcano Manor. Alright, Sanctuary Stone. Fan daggers. Ooh. Those are new, but they're not weapons, per se. They're things you throw. Fan daggers. Where are they? A set of knives, throwing knives bundled together. Concealed weapon cherished by the raptor assassins. Okay. I don't specifically know who the raptor assassins are. And let's find my first sight of grace. You know what? I know there's going to be one up here, so I'm going to go to the one up there. And then I'm going to come back down, because I do want to use this lift and come back up that way anyways. So, that'll be part of this. I don't know why I'm killing these guys. There's really no reason to. It's honestly just kind of a waste of time when I really think about it. I guess they were there, you know, as one of those things. Like, you were here, so I will take you out. Oh yeah, also there is a boss I want to go to around here too, just because it's fun for the lore of it, but we'll see how much time I have. Hopefully I can make it to him. Okay, we are now at the next major section that's going to lead us right to the map fragment, which is nice. And hey, look at that, look who moved. Alright, Bok is now moved.
Bok the Seamster, at your service, Master. Ready to make adjustments to your garments.
I think that really just tells you that Bok is... that this is the next major section, because before he was at the start of Liurnia, now he's at the start of the Erd Tree Gazing Hill. Straight up this way is going to be our map fragment for this section and a Golden Seed. Once you head to the right into the capital, there's four Golden Seas pretty much right off the bat, although I'm not going to do that right away for I don't know, just for reasons. I'll go there later, probably next episode. just don't have the time right now, and there's so many things to do, man. So many things to do. Hey, look who's here. Very nice.
Ah, look who we have here. How delightful to meet a familiar face, even after departing the Round Table Hold. I've been doing some learning of my own since then, actually, and will happily pass it along to you.
All right. What have you been doing? What have you been up to?
I'm yet to find the noble gold mask. I suppose he'll be closer to the Erd Tree. The path ahead might be perilous, but tread it I shall. Since departing the Round Table Hold, I've come to understand, in my solitude, how little it is I truly know.
So, Brother Korn is someone that you can actually screw up his questline by progressing too far before you progress his questline. I know because I did it. I never found him hanging out here. I found Gold Mask, who you have to do to progress his storyline, is find Gold Mask and then come back to him. But I didn't know. I progressed through this area before I saw him here, so I had no idea he'd gone here.
I'm yet to find them. I suppose the path ahead since departing the Round Table.
Okay, so that's going to be it for now. To progress the storyline, we need to find Gold Mask. All right, so finally, Altus Plateau map. Really expanding the map out nicely. Let's go to that and look at it. Altus Plateau. The Altus Plateau, where the Erd Tree's base can be found, contains the royal capital of Laendel to the east and Mount Gelmir to the west. Scars from the shattering remain apparent to this day. Alright, so now we have Altus Plateau open, and there is so much to explore here. Finger Reader Crone ahead, who I'm not going to head to quite yet, as I'm going to head back down here and use the lift of Dectus. I think this is the I think Dectus is the name of this one. Obviously, that right there will be something that we're going to come back to as well, but for now, I'm not in that area anyway, so it doesn't really matter to me to grab that map fragment. So, yeah, let's head back to Bellum Church and be annoyed that I still can't get invaded by Vike. I'm so annoyed! It's annoying! I think I've already spoken to her about everything she can say.
Special grapes, which only is without one.
Yeah. Oh, wow. There's a lot of golden centipedes here. I guess I'll take advantage of it. Granted, I don't remember what you can craft with them, but eh. You know what I feel like I need to upgrade again, actually, is my endurance. I've been doing vitality, but endurance is another one of those ones that's sort of just like a necessary, annoying one. More sword lore here. The first Liurnian War, Radagon's glory burns red as his hair. So, Radagon was the starter of the first Liurnian War, which I'm guessing was just against Rennala, right? Until they joined forces. Runark. But it is interesting to me that Radagon did it. What's Merica been up to this whole time? I don't know. You know what? I never killed this guy, and I never went up to that area to the top on my own, so now I'm really curious what's up there. Did I just kill that guy this time? I hope so. Oh my god, I didn't. Okay. Now I did. That's good. Aw, man. Okay. These things are so annoying once they get going. And obviously horseback doesn't help. There we go. Cool. Just because I want to go up to that campsite. And I guess take out the catapults too. That'd be nice. Which, like I said, I actually haven't done before on my own game. I just kind of just ran to the lift. So it'll be interesting for me just to see what's up here. No more operating the lift, please. Even though I'm assuming you come back to life if I die. Cuckoo, Glintstone. But yeah, this specific encampment over there is the one I'm wondering about. Because usually there's stuff in them, you know? Oh yeah, so there's a chest. I have to assume I never got before. Okay, not gonna work out for me there. Stop running away, would ya? Thank you. No more lift. Or catapult, whatever. No more! Now for the exciting part. What could it possibly be? Da na 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 na. Dun, 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 dun. A great mace. That was some Zelda music for you. Where be my weapons? Great mace. Maintains all the advantages of smaller bludgeons, boasting few deficiencies, while being very capable at breaking enemy guards and stances. A shrewd choice for simple slugging matches. Okay, cool. I'm happy I got it. So, I guess that clears up the road then, looks like, for me to head up this lift. Hit up the lift. I know, I actually don't know if there's any sites of grace around it. There's none that I know of offhand. Also, there's a merchant here. Did I go to that merchant? I know I got that site of grace. That's good. I couldn't remember if I had or hadn't, since it's been so long since I played. But yeah, I don't know offhand of any sites of grace around the Grand Lift of Dectus. Hopefully there's one inside, just to make it easier if I ever want to come back here. That's obviously to go to the madness-inducing area. So it's probably not going to be anything there, since there's one like right up top I learned about during the Let's Plays. Dragon Wound Grease. Very nice. And, okay. Looks like nothing important up here. I didn't think there was... Oh, wait. Is that a... No. I thought maybe I saw something sparkling. Okay. Hey, good. There is a site of grace here. Nice. Granted, I don't think I can level up, but... Grand Lift of Dectus. Okay, we can activate it. We have both medallions. It's there somewhere. Another path leading back to the foot of the Erd Tree. An ancient tunnel. Yeah, they give you so many hints about it. About the rune-filled precipice. And ravine-veiled village. But... I can do the Grand Lift of Dectus, so... Hey, let's do it. Although first, let me double check that there's nothing on this side. Okay, I guess not. Get ready for a minor cutscene. Very, very minor, in fact. Okay, I don't know why I didn't talk during any of that, but you could just enjoy. I'm just used to shutting up during cutscenes, even though there wasn't much to that one. Okay, so I want to find if there's any site of grace up here, but I really don't know if there is. The first site of grace really just might be that first one that I found. Actually, you know what? I think there's one just to the left over there, now that I think about it. Hey, more of these Clockwork Knight guys. Welcome to Laendell, they say. I guess it kind of shows you that these guys are pretty related to Laendell. If we found one up atop in Laendell, right? Guarding up there. And now I'm finding this other one here. And the other one we saw was guarding the fort. And the fort, I think he's doing all this stuff for the Golden Order. So, I'm guessing that's what these were created for, was... those guys specifically. Keep on looking at the time, like, do I have time for this boss fight? Do I? Wow, I'm just like destroying these guys. And they gave me a lot of runes, surprisingly. think some of the runes are a little weird for how you get them. Oh, Golem Great Bow. That's pretty sick. Golem Great Bow. Let me take a look at that real quick. Great Bow of Blackstone crafted by a civilization now gone to ruin. Extremely... Is the civilization of golems? Extremely heavy, this Great Bow requires enormous strength just to draw, suggesting it was not designed for human use. Okay. To my left. I'm gonna check to see if I was right that there's a site of grace around here. It'll be easier to find since it's nighttime, hopefully. Wow, this looks so cool at night. There it is. There it is. Okay. Good. I'm hoping I can level up before I go fight the boss thing I'm gonna do. Because I want to do it. I think it'd be fun. I can't. Oh, I'm like right there. Let's see what this is first. And what's up? Oh, wait. This is the ruins. To get to the other part of the ruins. The Lux ruins I wanted to explore. You know what? I'm going to do that for now. Because I was talking about it earlier and wanting to go up here. So it's just nice to get right to the other side of it. Find some demi-human chiefs that, again, easier than Mount Gelmir. So, did not mean to overlevel myself at all, but whatever. You know, it kind of happened. Also, the fact that I'm going to every single area and basically 100%ing it, it's just kind of naturally going to happen in a way. Then again, like, once you get later in the game, you just, there's no overleveling later in the game, in my opinion. Although, I don't know, maybe it's just the way I play, because, like, I've watched, I know that there are people who just own some of the later parts of the game where I'm just like, Jesus, that, some of that stuff from those bosses just obliterated me. Alright, some string. Golden rune, 3, okay. I'm hearing something around here. There it is. Ash of War Shield Crash. Nope. I was gonna look at it, and I thought there might be an enemy, and so there was. Alright, Ash of War Shield Crash, and then I'll go in here. Oh, there's a boss? Okay. Ash of War Shield Crash. Oh, man. Right when I found where it was, of course. How dare you guys? Another one? Another one! Okay. I was just seeing if there's some other ruins that I've missed and forgot about. Alright. Ash of War Shield Crash. Excuse me for that interruption. Shield Crash. Two-hand the shield and charge forward while maintaining guard. Weaker enemies will be shoved backwards and can even be staggered. Okay. Once again, Ash of War is typically not giving much lore. You know what I never realized is that you can use Torrent for these fights. Another Demi-Human Queen. It's interesting that there's so many Demi-Human Queens up here. I mean, the other ones were in Mount Gelmir, but still, this is like the third one this episode, right? Wait, no, I fought one last episode, but one last episode to this episode. That's pretty crazy. Enemy felled. Yes. A lot easier than the last one. A lot easier. Oh, man. Whoops. Whoops again about Altus Plateau. Ritual Sword Talisman. Nice. And let's take a look at that. A talisman pattern after swords used in ritual combat held to honor the Urgery. The practice had died out by the age of King Consort Radigan, but remains of the arenas where ritual combat took place can still be found in every land. Raises attack power when HP is at maximum. So these would be the various arenas that we find throughout the game. Like, first big example is the one over here. I'm sure drove a lot of people crazy, including myself, when you first find it, because it's like, wait, how do I get in it? Brother Corn, wow. Just like looking at all these guys here. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and do this, even though at this point I think I've been pretty much exactly an hour, because I only died once, I think. But you know what? It's for the fun. It's for the fun. And let's level up. So I can feel like I nicely explored this area anyways. Okay, getting another vigor. I've just been doing vigor, and I really want to start pumping stuff back into strength. And like I said, endurance, but that's okay. This is just smart to do. Because it's one of those stats you don't want to level up, but you should. Because it's not a fun stat. I say that when I'm sure there's a lot of people who love leveling up vigor. I don't know. Yeah, I think there's actually a cave to get down through that area, if I remember correctly. Because, actually, that's like the first area I found when I was trying to get up here, was that cave. So, we're actually going to have to go back through here. Cave, whatever, like, you know, full passage underground. And hey, spirit jellyfish. Alright. But a friendly one. Unless I attack it. Yeah, this is the cave I was talking about. Hefty beast bone. I've been wanting to talk about this for a while. I haven't had many people I can talk to about this, and then I went on my honeymoon and wedding right around the time that people were finally at a point where I could start talking about this. But it's been on my mind a lot, and I've been wanting to bring it up. So I'm glad I can finally go here and talk about this and talk to you guys about it. The Golden Lineage Everjail. All right, Golden Lineage. Why would someone from the Golden Lineage be in an Everjail is a big question of mine. So who should we find in the Golden Lineage Everjail but Godefroy the Grafted, who notably is different from Godfrey. So it's another one of the brothers. Godfrey's kind of like the baby one that nobody likes. So, yeah. Makes me wonder a lot about Godefroy here. What did he do to piss everybody off to be put into an Everjail? I'd like to know. One and... Oh, okay. I thought maybe I was early there. So, I'm really not playing cleverly against him, if I'm being honest. Oh my god, how did I not get hit there? I've been playing so stupid, and I know it. I'm well aware of it. Nope, and nope. Wow, lucky me. Before he goes into his next form. The next phase of Godefroy. At least I think he has another phase, right? Yeah, me doing these double hits is really stupid. God, I'm gonna get so screwed there. Might even die because of what I just did there. Okay. Yeah, that was really dumb. I need to start doing single hits and stop being such a moron. It's just not fun, you know? It's just not as fun. Pretty annoyed with myself for getting hit there, but hey. Alright, there you go. One and two, and then I'll run in and get an attack here, hopefully, in. Boom, nice. Yeah, so this is actually really what trained me for Godfrey. Was doing this Godefroy attack. Godefroy, whatever. I mean, there's a lot of twins in this game, so it's possible this is just a twin or something. Or, like, there's a lot of characters who kind of have, like, two names. But I really do think that this one's a different character. That said, it is something that I'm going to have to look more into before I can just say that, as there are so many twins in this game. Or not twins, sorry. There's so many, like, alternate versions of characters or twins. There's, like, all of that stuff. So, yeah. Gotta go to the left side this time for that one. Oh, okay. I couldn't remember for a second which attack that was going to be. I don't know why, he does it all the time. I should easily remember that one. Nice. Oh, why did I go for a double attack there? That was really stupid. I mean, it worked out, but it was stupid, you know? Now I can go for a double and probably get away with it. No, to be honest, I wasn't expecting this to go well on the first try. I probably am a little over-leveled. Godfrey icon. But, yeah. Godfrey, not Godfroy, or Godfrey, as this one was, and not Godfrey. It definitely is different than Godfrey, though, just by the way he looks and everything. Godfrey's pretty specific. Okay, anyways, let's look at it. So, a legendary talisman. This is going to be another one that you need for the achievement, then. Depicting the Elden Lord Godfrey. Raises charge attack powers of sorcerer's incantations and skills. Godfrey was a ferocious warrior. When he vowed to become a lord, he took the beast regent Sarosh on his back to suppress the ceaseless lust for battle that raged within. So he probably became lord, or the golden lord, by virtue of being an incredible warrior and murdering a lot of people, and then had to suppress it clearly with Sarosh. So that's what that at least says to me. Yeah, so Golden Lineage Ever Jail is pretty cool. And again, I really do want to hear your guys' thoughts on this. I haven't looked at any lore videos or any theories or anything, and I've just now, as I've mentioned, starting to compile all like the item descriptions and dialogue and all that to start really getting my mind on what I think's been going on and everything, and where I can start imparting that and talking about that and discussing with you guys. But the nice thing is, the further I come here, the more stuff we can talk about. Oh, there was another path here, as it turns out. Yeah, so the further I come and the further I get, the more of this stuff we can talk about, which is pretty nice. So, all right, let me warp here. Actually, yeah, you know what? I'll do this one first, this path. I think. I'm trying to decide. Oops. No, I meant to level up. Excuse me. Let me get the level up in. Vigor or endurance, as I've been talking about it. Get back to my strength again. Let's do another vigor. This has been a lot of vigor lately, but it's getting to the point where I can start to feel comfortable and move to raising other stats. So I'm debating right now if next episode I'm going to go up this way, to Finger Reader Crone, and then basically do a bunch of stuff over here, or if what I'd rather do is go down through here, take on that dungeon up there, and then actually take on this area next episode. So I'll figure that out, what I want to do next episode, as we've done so much Mount Gelmir. I don't have to worry about Mount Gelmir for a little bit. I'll come back and take care of the things and wrap up the little minor dungeons and bosses I haven't done before I head to the Volcano Manor. But I'm probably going to do Kaled first, honestly. So I'm probably not going to go back to Mount Gelmir for a while. It's probably going to be doing a lot of Altus Plateau, wrapping that up, and then heading to Kaled and wrapping up Kaled, and then coming back to Mount Gelmir. But anyways, happy that this episode ended up going so well after last episode was so rough. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Later, guys. Peace. Hey!